Hello students, I would like to welcome all of you in course of heat and mass transfer. So I am not going to start from conduction and convection because that I have already completed in classroom. So in radiation also we have almost completed around 40 to 50% of the portion, right? So I am going to start from midway. If you have any doubts, you can ask me separately on my WhatsApp, right? Because we have already made WhatsApp and we are already having Google Classroom, and where I already uploaded all the documents, all the assignments and some tutorials also, and I asked you to submit assignments also, right? So I think you are submitting those assignments. So now we will start radiation. So this is the outline, right? So we are having some topics. What I did, I divided bigger topic into a smaller topic, like we follow divide and rule policy, right? So first I will be explaining what is radiosity, then we'll move forward toward heat transfer. That is our main objective, to find out radiation heat transfer, right? So actually already I have explained radiosity in classroom, right? But we need to brush up those concepts again, right? So before going into radiosity, I have to just revise what are all these things: alpha, rho and tau, right? What is alpha? Alpha is absorptivity, right? So what is absorptivity? It is the ratio of absorbed radiation divided by incident radiation, right? So any surface, whenever any radiation falls onto the surface, it will absorb some amount of radiation, okay? So fraction of that radiation that it will absorb is called absorptivity. In the same way, what is reflectivity? Because whenever any radiation will falls onto surface, it will reflect it back, okay? Because it is not a black body. In black body, what happens? Black body has alpha is equal to 1, means it will absorb all the incident radiation, but normal bodies or gray body, it cannot absorb all of the incident radiation, right? So it will deflect some of it, and that fraction is called reflectivity. Same way transmittivity, okay? Transmissivity, what is transmissivity? Whenever radiation falls on the surface, it will allow some amount of radiation to pass it through, right? Some amount of radiation will pass through the surface, right? But in our course, we are not going to study any surface, through which radiations are getting transferred, okay? So we are going to study only opaque surface, right? What is the meaning of opaque surface? Opaque surface means it should be having transmittivity equal to 0, right? And I told you, sum of all these alpha, rho and tau should be equal to 1, right? So in our case, whatever we will study, tau will always remain 0, right? Tau means transmissivity, right? So addition of alpha, that is absorptivity, plus reflectivity should be equal to 1, right? So now we will come to radiosity. Radiosity also I have already explained in classroom, so we need to just brush up the knowledge, brush up the concept, okay? So the total radiation energy leaving a surface per unit time and per unit area is the radiosity. So in simple language, total radiation, whatever radiation is coming out of the surface, right? So suppose we are having this surface here, okay? So whatever radiation is coming out of the surface, that radiation is called radiosity, okay? So one part of the radiosity will be the emitted radiation. What is emitted radiation? Surface, because of its own temperature. Suppose this surface is at T temperature. So because of this temperature, it will radiate some energy. Okay, it will radiate some amount of radiation, right? So that is called emitted radiation. And how do we find out the value of emitted radiation? So if we know the radiation of black body, okay, at the same temperature, T, right, then we have to just multiply radiation or radiative power of the black body with emissivity, right? What is emissivity? Emissivity is nothing but emitted radiation from a surface divided by emitted radiation from black body, right? That is called emissivity, right? So if we know emissivity of our body, then we can just simply multiply it with emissive power of black body, right? In that way we can find out emitted radiation. Okay, what is reflected radiation? Okay, so what happens on any surface, some amount of, you know, radiation will be incident over there, right? Some amount of radiation will fall onto the surface, okay, and some amount of that it will reflect, some amount of that it will absorb, right? So whatever amount of incident radiation surface is going to reflect is called reflected radiation, right? And we have to add this reflected radiation with emitted radiation, then sum of both these things will become radiosity, right? Okay, so how do we find out reflected radiation if we know the G? So I think you already know what is the meaning of G. So G is incident radiation, and what do we call it in our subject? It is called irradiation, right? That I have already explained in previous classes. Amount of radiation that is falling onto surface is called irradiation, and we represent it with capital G, right? So when you multiply capital G with rho, that is the reflectivity. As we already know, rho is the reflectivity of the surface, then we can easily find out whatever amount of, you know, radiation is getting reflected. Okay, so sum of reflected radiation plus emitted radiation is called radiosity. Okay, and we are going to represent radiosity with capital J here, right? And we are having this subscript I here, right? And this I will represent surface, because in heat transfer we will be having many surfaces, and we are going to give each surface a number, right? Suppose this surface is number 1, and there will be some other surface that will be number 2, right, or number 3. So this subscript will represent the number of the surface. Okay, so it is just an identification number. So we are going to represent radiosity with capital J subscript I. Okay, and it should be equal to radiation emitted by surface plus radiation reflected by the surface. As I already told you, what is the radiation emitted by the surface? Epsilon of the surface multiplied by black body radiation at the same temperature. Okay, so whatever temperature this body is having, at that temperature we need to find out black body emissive power, right? Or black body emissive radiation, right? And you have to multiply them, then you can find out radiation emitted by the surface. Okay, and how do we find out radiation reflected by the surface? You have to multiply irradiation, that is capital G, with reflectivity of the surface. Okay, so once you do the sum of these two things, you will be getting J, that is called radiosity, right? And we already know what is, because we are analyzing a surface that is opaque, right? And what is the meaning of opaque? Opaque means it should have 2 is equal to 0, right? It should have transmissivity equal to 0. Okay, and in equilibrium, whenever any surface is in equilibrium, its alpha, that is absorptivity, should be equal to epsilon, right? What is epsilon? It is emissivity. Okay, that is a Kirchhoff law that I think I have already explained it to you in class, right? So you should always remember, in our heat transfer course, alpha is always equal to epsilon. Okay, whatever amount of, you know, energy it is getting absorbed, okay, whatever fraction of the energy is getting absorbed, same fraction is getting emitted. Okay, so emissivity and absorptivity should be equal, and that we found out from Kirchhoff law that I have already explained in classroom, right? If you have any doubt, you can ask me on my WhatsApp number that I have already given you, right? So we can easily find out, like, alpha plus rho is equal to 1 for an opaque surface, and here alpha is equal to epsilon, right? So epsilon plus rho is equal to 1. So from here we can find out what is rho, what is the value of rho. Rho should be equal to 1 minus epsilon, okay, that only we replaced here. Okay, we replaced this rho with 1 minus epsilon, right, because this epsilon is equal to alpha, that is absorptivity, right. So after rearranging this equation, J equal to epsilon capital E B plus 1 minus epsilon capital G. After rearranging this equation, we can find out the value of G. In the next video, I will be going to tell you why I am finding out capital G, right. And this capital G is called irradiation, okay. And we will be getting this equation after rearranging the equation above, right. Okay, so now I have a question for you. The radiosity of a black body is equal to its emissive power, okay. So you have to just think about it. Why radiosity of a black body is equal to its emissive power, right? What is radiosity? Radiosity is the radiation that is coming out of the surface. It is not only emitted by the surface, it is getting reflected also, right? So it is addition of reflected radiation plus emitted radiation, okay. So in black body, what happens? It will absorb all of the reflected radiation, okay. So because black body absorbs all of the reflected radiation, this part will become zero, right. And as we already know, for a black body, epsilon equal to 1, right. So whatever amount of radiation is falling onto the surface is getting absorbed in black body, right. So for a black body, radiosity, that is J, should be equal to emissive power of black body, right. So with this, I want to conclude this lecture. It is a short lecture, and we are going to make many short lectures, right, because it is not possible to upload a big file. So we have to upload topic wise, okay, each file, okay. So now we'll meet in next lecture.